Name's Cameron. Detective Cameron. It's a Wednesday afternoon, and I had the cheesies. I needed to get to some cheese quick. A local family obliged to take me down to the local Walmart to get me a brick. The drive was long and slow, but not long enough. I couldn't wait to get my hands on that cheese. It was gonna be a dream. We pulled into the Walmart parking lot. There were a lot of people. Maybe too many people, but I didn't care. I took the risk anyway. We sat there, waiting for people to pass by in the parking lot entrance. I told them to go ahead and find a parking spot, as we'd been sitting there for a long time. Seemed like too long. The Walmart supermarket was scaring me already. I told them just to get it over with. We pulled in. About 30 rows or so down, we decided to park. The parking spot was parking C. There were lots of oil everywhere. But I felt like a million bucks then, and I knew no oil would stop me from getting my cheese. We pulled forward in the next lane, just in case. I felt different, as no one else was wearing the proper clothing as I was. But no matter. I walked back the fruits and vegetables. All those candied apples and sugar items, whatever you'd like to call them. So wonderful. The cheese aisle was way in the back of the store, so I knew I had a lot of walking to do. I was happy enough that I could probably jump to the moon and back. As soon as I saw that cheese, I made a break for it. I couldn't wait. I went and grabbed the brick from the bottom shelf. It looked okay, but just to be sure, I grabbed out my trusty magnifying glass, which I'd had for about 25 minutes now. I looked at the expiration date. Everything seemed to check out. I knew this would be the right time to get some cheese. I felt like $100, considering that's probably what I would have spent. Instead, I spent $100. And possibly, one penny. A local fellow said he needed one more penny just to pay for it. So I gave him one. We were buds. Little did I know he would turn on me. As soon as I got home, I started cutting my star-shaped cheese for my new cheese and cracker recipe. It was gonna be great. I couldn't wait to try it. But then the unthinkable happened. I sliced right through the middle of the cheese. I was devastated. I kindly called back the family. They said they'd take me back to Walmart, so I stormed down to the cheese section once more. I ran and grabbed the same kind of brick, hoping I wouldn't make the mistake I had. I once again furiously checked the expiration date. I didn't care, though. It was all the same to me now. As I was walking out, I noticed the fellow had borrowed the penny. I remembered he hadn't paid me back. I started to chase after him, but he noticed me. So I tried to be sneaky about it. I hid behind some mayonnaise, thinking that'd be the perfect spot. But I turned the corner, and he was gone. I ran down the hard tile, my footsteps echoing. I looked in every possible spot where he might be, but all the modernized food canisters were in the way. I casually walked across the middle of the aisle, hoping nobody would think it strange that I was running. I looked into the Huggies. Might I mention that the Huggies stand was a little too low? I peered down every hallway that I could see. He wasn't there. Looked under all the boxes, just in case a clue. Then, out of the corner of my eye, I saw. I ran, and he ran too. I casually walked, hoping that nobody would find it suspicious. Tried to make it tricky. He pushed the bystander out of the way. That's about all I saw. I tried to follow him best I could, but he was too quick. He thought he had lost me. I could hear his breathing from 2 rows away. Then, when he saw me, I knew he was in for it. He ran. Then, I turned the corner, and he was gone again. He was just too quick for me. Then, I saw a new plasma TV. I set down my cheese to go check it out. Even though I was still trying to focus on the TV, that cheese just couldn't escape my mind. Just about the same time when I went to go look, he stopped by, leaned on the cheese, and his world turned upside down. He started falling to the ground on his knees. Seemed like it was poison to him. I went over and grabbed him and pulled him into the aisle. I didn't want any witnesses. I pulled him and put him against the bar. And I knew he knew I meant business. I told him that he hadn't paid me back yet, and he and I discussed. He offered me my magnifying glass, which I don't know how he got it, but it seemed like a fair trade to me. I helped him up. I think he knew that we were okay now, but I knew I had to hurry home because I didn't have a ride. Then, about halfway, I realized I'd forgotten my cheese. I ran back as fast as I could and grabbed that wonderful, wonderful piece of cheese. I patted it and ran off again. On my way out the store, I checked out, met a few people, said hello. Then I buckled up and I prepared myself for that most wonderful piece of cheese. Case solved. Today was a good day, and I knew that.